Let me start on this problem. As I show you, we are working on what's so called the static tree in determinate structure. And now we are working on the frame and we focus on the problem that has the degree of indeterminacy equal to 1. So the problem that we have is something like the one that's shown over here. This structure, this frame, has the fixed support at A and has the lower support at C. By considering this, you guys may have three unknown over here, A sub Y, A sub X, and the moment M sub A. And another one, lower, you have this one for C sub Y. So you have unknown for four. And then you have one degree of one free body diagram. So you have three equations. By doing this, the unknown 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. What kind of frame should have 1 degree of indeterminacy? We have the frame such as this one, pin. This kind of frame also has 4 unknown and minus 3 equation of equilibrium. You have the frame with 1 degree of indeterminacy. Even you put the column for this kind of frame, this frame also has 1 degree of indeterminacy or something else. You may have, like the previous example, fixed support over here and the lower supports over here, as you may have from the homework. This one also, what we consider the indeterminate frame with 1 degree of indeterminacy. So we focus our study on this kind of problem, because solving this kind of problem by hand is going to require a lot of effort. Now, you should read the problem statement clearly. Problem statement on this problem said, this beam has the fractional rigidity 2EI, and this column have rigidity 2EI. Sometimes they may have 2EI over here, just 1EI over here, or only 1EI over here and 2EI over here, or both have only 1EI. Okay, it depends on the problem that's going to affect when you calculate the deflection, then put it in the compatibility condition. And then you base up on the principle of superposition, and we have discussed the consistent deformation method, or the method of consistent deformation. This is up on this. When you get the frame with 1 degree of indeterminacy, you should select one of this reaction as the redundant. And the best way to select it, you should select the one that stand alone. This problem, you select C sub Y as redundant to make it to be the unknown. And based upon this method, as you know, we use force as the unknown. We use this as the redundant force. And then you must refer by using the principle of superposition. You will separate the frame into two cases. And by doing this, you got to what? You got to draw this one. Okay, let's see. This is 10 meter. Let's put it into 25 millimeter and have this one 8 meter. Just put it into 2 meter. So your structure will be changed. You take the roller out and put the reaction C sub Y as the redundant. So the frame on the left is going to be equivalent to the frame on the right. And then you got to separate this frame into two cases. This one will equal to one we call the primary frame. Okay, and another one we will put the redundant force apply concrete. For the primary frame, the structure simply subjected to the given loading, and then you plus it with another one that is subjected to the redundant force. So you may get the frame to be two determinate frame. When you combine these two statically determinate frame, you get this statically indeterminate frame with 1 degree of indeterminacy. And then you got to use the concept of elastic work based upon this. Under the application of the force, your frame may have deformation, and the deformation supposed to draw properly. Okay, for this 60 kilonewton and 20 kilonewton, both loading produce the moment on the column and the beam. So column curve being the curve, and then they're supposed to keep this right angle, and then you get the deflection that corresponding to the C sub Y. And this is Poiseuille. You may call it just delta C Y, or some people may like it to be V sub C Y. They are the same. And under the application of this one, the frame will deflect something like this. And the column and the beam must be curved, and you get this one as the deformation. You may call it to be delta palm sub CY. Since C sub Y is unknown, we select to put C sub Y into one, and then this is going to be F sub C Y CY, and then time the unknown C sub Y. So based upon this, you may go to the second step. On the second step, we have the compatibility condition. And the compatibility condition is at what? At A. Okay. And by doing this, what you have is the deflection over here is zero. And then it's equivalent to this one. It's equal to this one is downward. So you put downward is positive. So delta sub CY. And this one is opposite. It's going to be F sub CY F at C. Okay. And the force at C in the Y direction, if you prefer. So you may put CY, CY, or you may put just F sub C, F sub C is okay. Okay, and then this one is time C sub Y. And then what you have is going to be C sub Y is going to be what? Delta sub CY, if you may put it delta sub cy divided by f sub cy. Okay, if you prefer, later you will get the value of the reaction c sub y. Now the problem move to the step that require you to determine the defection. And as you may recall from previous chapter, and you have examination already, usually this one supposed to be very easy. But anyway, let me trying to go back and recall you guys how we analyze for the defection delta sub cy and f sub cy. And as we put it in the step over here, that's going to be step number 3. We will find the diffraction delta sub cy and f sub cy. And you may refer by using, you have only one method, the method of virtual work to method of virtual work. And by doing this, you let us start by determine this delta sub cy. We will put 1.0 unit load in this frame, and then it will time delta sub cy, and then it's going to equal to integration of the moment. This one will provide the moment m. Okay, and then you may think, you may put the 1.0 unit load, and then the unit load will be applied at point C in this same direction 1.0. So based upon this, you will get the moment small m. Let me put it in red, so it's going to be m. And then you integrate it dx by divided by ei. And then what you do is you got to select what going to be the coordinate for your integration. So based upon this, you have column and you have the beam. So I allow you to select as you like. Let me put it into x1, and I put this one into x1. If I put like this, the same thing will occur over here. Okay, I must put the same coordinate for this one and for this one. So based upon this, let me do the computation. Let me find the small m first, and later I will determine the capital M. Okay, and you may consider under the application of the 1.0, you have this one A sub X, A sub Y, and M sub A. And then if you just do the summation of F sub X equal to 0, what you get is A sub X on this problem is going to be 0. And if you put summation of F sub Y equal to 0, A sub Y will be 1.0. And if you do the summation of the moment at A equal to 0, take the moment over here, the load 1.0 is in this direction times the moment arm of 8 meter, and it is in the opposite of M sub A. So this one supposed to be 8.0. And now you may start by cutting this frame. And for this one is referring to X1. And again, you have this one for 1.0 and the moment over here of 8.0. And then if you do the summation of the moment equal to zero, just put in this direction, you may get m1. It's in the same direction as this 8, okay, 8.0 moment. And then this is going to be 8. And if you cut this one and draw the free body diagram over here, this is going to be 1.0. And reference to this one is going to be x2. And what you get, use the moment according to our psi convention, you get this one as the m2. And this one is going to be what? Minus x2, right? It's in the same direction. So when you move from the left to the right, you get this one. And then let me put this one and say this is m2. And let me put this one in the green. And let's say m1 is going to be 8. So let me move to this one. And if you may work, I recommend you guys move this one to over here. And then what we have is 60 kilonewton. And this one is 20. Sorry, this one must be straight, right? 20 kilonewton per meter. So under this, we have again a sub y, this one for a sub x, and this one for moment m sub a. And I recall from the previous one, this is 8 meter, this is 10 meter. Summation of x sub x equal to 0. What you get is a sub x is going to be 60 kilonewton, right? This one is going to be 60 kilonewton. And then you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0. A sub Y is going to be 20 and it's going to time 8. Okay, that is going to be 160 kilonewton. And then if you do the summation moment at A equal to 0, you will get M sub A in this direction. It's going to be in the opposite direction, equal to 60 times 10 plus this one is 160. And over here, the moment arm gonna be 160 times 4. So your M sub A, when you put it, it's going to be 1,240 kilonewton meter. Okay, and then you should not compute over here. But anyway, let me cut this one again to be this x1. So put this one again to x1. And then you get this one for moment m sub a. And you have this one for 160 kilonewton. And you have this one for 60 kilonewton. And based upon this computation of moment, you're gonna use the same moment direction and summation of the moment equal to 0. And then what you get is going to be the moment over here. Let's call it m1. Okay, take moment over here. This m1 in the same direction as 1,240 kilonewton, and it opposite to this. So this m1 will equal to 60 times x1. And since this one in the same direction, so minus 1,240, that is going to be your capital M1, the moment due to the applied loading. And then do the same thing, just cut it over here and you will get this portion for the X2, what we have is uniformly distributed load X in this X2. Use the same sign convention over here. Summation of the moment equal to zero. And then you may see this one going to be 20 X2. So the moment M2 is going to be 20 X2 time X2 divided by 2. So it's going to be 10 times X2 square. And let me again put it in this color. Now you are ready to put all of your moment into this equation. Now you have delta sub cy, and then it's going to be equal to the first one. Do the integration m1. Okay, let's say this is going to be from point A to point D, and from 0 to 10 meter, that is going to be 8. And then that's going to time 60 x1 and minus 1240 and dx1 over the column 2 2 ei. Okay, and then you have another one plus you do the integration for this one. That is integrate for the beam. That is from this point to this point. That is 8 meter. So 0 to 8, and you has the m2. This is 10 x2 square, and you time it with this one minus, let's put it in this color, minus x2, and that is going to be dx2 by 2ei. And if you put everything together, okay, and do the integration, you will get this first one minus 75,200 divided by 2ei. And another one, you get minus for this one, 10,240 divided by 2ei. And then if you combine them together, you get this one to be 4,720 divided by ei. And take the negative, that means, sorry, it's not should be negative, it should be positive, sorry. It's supposed to be positive because it's in the same direction of this. You may check, oh, this is wrong. Okay, this must be negative and negative. So this one must be negative and this one positive. Okay, and then for this one, you take the moment here. Oh, this one also minus 8. This one minus 8 because it's in the same direction. See, it should be minus 8. And this one is correct. This one is correct. And when you get this one, so this one in the downward direction. And now you may go a little bit further. Just put 1.0. time f sub cy, cy equal to, that means you got to consider this one. You change this one to 1.0, and it's going to be similar to this, but it's just only in opposite direction. So based upon this, you will change the capital M to small m. And you may use this one, okay, but it's going to be in the opposite direction. Don't worry, because it's going to be m multiplied by m. And then you do the integration the dx divided by ei. And nearly every problem you may see, you may use this one to compute this one, even though the direction they are in the opposite. But since they multiply together, so you may just integrate of this one minus h square and dx1 by 2ei from 0 to 10. That is going to be your first term. And the next, you do the integration now for this one, 0 to 8. And the moment is going to be this one minus x2 square dx2 over 2ei. So don't worry, this one is square, also this one. So you may get the result for f sub cy cy to be the number of what of let me check for let me put it into like this, it's going to be 640 over 2ei, 640 over 2ei, and it's going to plus this one, it's going to be 170.6. okay, let me put it into 170.6, 170.67 divided by 2ei. And when you compute it, you will get this one to be 405.33 divided by ei. See, now your work is going to be harder than chapter 7. You must be able to solve this kind of diffraction and this kind of diffraction. But usually, as you may see in my problem that's in your hand, sometimes I provide you guys one of the diffraction. For example, I give this value for you guys already, but you supposed to be able to draw the elastic curve like this and show this is going to be delta sub c y. So I will help you one of this diffraction. But if the other problem on the beam is easy or problem on the task is easy, you may need to do this kind of calculation. Okay, so just be prepared to solve for both the diffraction due to the loading or the diffraction just due to the redundant force when you assume it to be 1.0. And now we move to step number 4. On the next step, we just compute find the reaction C sub y, and then you have C sub y over here. Thing going to be very easy. C sub y going to be 42,720 divided by ei, and then it must be divided by f sub cy cy. So 405.33, and then what you have is divided by ei. You can move it upward, okay, and then you just put them together, you get it to be 105.4, okay, for significant figure, that's good enough. And then you just put this one, 105.4, it's going to be 105.4 kilonewton, and it's going to be 105.4 kilonewton and upward. And then you may put again into this one, 105.4 kilonewton. And at this point, okay, you should be able to determine the reaction. So next step, okay, we will find the reactions and draw. Okay, you will require to draw from this one, shear diagram, moment diagram. Actually, later supposed to be the elastic curve. You may draw a shear diagram, moment diagram, and let's put the elastic curve also. Now you may come over here, and again, this is going to be a sub y. This is going to be a sub x, and then this is going to be m sub a. And you may do some computation over here, and you may summation of the moment, take moment at a equal to zero. So in this way, a sub x and a sub y will make zero moment. So basis upon this, you get the m sub a. So put this one and m sub a. And then what you have is c sub y rotate in the same direction at m sub a. So put to be, this is going to be 8 meter plus 8 times 105.4 in this direction. 60 produce the moment in the opposite direction. So 60 gonna time 10 meter, 60 times 10. And you also has this one for 20 times 8, 160 kilonewton. And this is gonna be 4 meter plus 160 and times 4. By doing this, you will get m sub a over here to be 396.8 kilonewton meter. And then you do the summation of x sub x equal to zero. A sub x, very simple in this direction, and it's going to be 60 kilonewton. And then the last one is over here. Summation of f sub y equal to zero. Your a sub y is upward. So a sub y, and then plus this one, 105.4. And then this one is 160 in opposite direction. So a sub y, you will get it to be 160 minus 105.4. So your a sub y will be 54.6 kilonewton. Now, again, drawing the shear diagram moment diagram basis upon this, you may let me put this one to be the column. Let's put it into, this is 10 meter, right? 10 meter, just put it into 4 centimeter each, well, 2.5, okay. And then over here, 8 each centimeter, 3.5, and then this is about 8 centimeter, and this is 8 meter under 20 kilonewton per meter. Just put it over here, so you will have this portion C, and this one is going to be 105.4 kilonewton. And then it require you to determine the shear force over here. So basis upon this, this is 105.4. okay, so this one will equal to 160 minus this one. So this one supposed to be the same as before, 54 0.6 as same as A sub Y kilonewton. And also, if you don't want to compute over here, you may come over here. What we have the reaction over here is this one is 160 kilonewton. Sorry, it's just 60 kilonewton. 60 kilonewton, 54.6, 54.6 kilonewton. And the moment over here, 396.8. So this one, 396.8 kilonewton meter. Okay, you may do the computation for this one. Okay, and then don't forget you got this point B, and the point B has this one 60 kilonewton. Okay, so if you determine the end shear end moment over here, and you would like to transfer to here, you got to consider over here. For me, it's going to be simpler for me to determine the moment over here. I do the summation of the moment equal to zero. So the moment here, okay, in this direction is going to be plus this one is 160 times 4, and this one equal to 105.4 times 8. If you compute it, you will get this one for 203.4 kilonewton meter. Okay, and then at this point, you may put this one summation of F sub Y, and you will get the same over here. It's going to be 54.6 kilonewton. And this one downward, this one upward, this one downward, and this one upward. This is going to be 54.6 kilonewton. So it is correct. Now, if you do the summation of X sub X equal to zero, this 60, right? And then you will get this one to be 60 kilonewton. And that's going to produce this one to be 60 kilonewton. So due to these two, you will get zero normal force and zero normal force over here. And the last one that you're going to compute is the moment. So you're going to get the moment for this one. If you take the moment over here, M over here is in this direction. And then you will get this one, 396.8 in opposite direction, 396.8. And this one is 60. Okay, so by doing this, the moment may not be in the correct direction. Let me put it over here. So if we summation of the moment equal to zero and put it in this counterclockwise direction, so this one must plus M, and this one must plus 60 times 10 meter, and then it's going to be 600. So our M over here will be, according to my calculation, 203.2. So this is 203.2, and this moment will transfer to this moment and transfer to this moment and then transfer to this moment. Okay, they are balanced. Now you may start to draw your shear diagram, moment diagram, and sometimes also the normal force diagram. Let me start by the normal force diagram. It is, should be easiest one. And then you may see this is in compression So your normal force is going to be, let me put it into this direction, n kilonewton minus 54.6, and then over here minus 54.6, and we call this n diatom. Okay, and then let me zoom it a little bit over here. We may select to draw the what the shear diagram, and you can see this 60 is going to be upward. So I just put this one and this one to be X meter, and this one V in kilonewton, and 60 upward. So what we have is going to be positive shear, right? So plus 60, and dV by dx equal to 0 because no W. So this one is plus 60. And the last one you may put, it is going to be the moment diagram. So basis on this M kilonewton meter, this X meter from 0 to 10 meter. What we have is the moment over here, 396.8, is counterclockwise, so it's negative. You may put this one to be, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's maybe about this point. That's going to be minus 396.8. And then the shear always positive. So the my dx is equal to plus 60. And if you consider this one, put the same cosine convention as we have, this sine convention and this moment 203.2 have the opposite direction. So it means this moment is going to be positive. So you may put this one plus 203.2, and then you may draw the diagram over here, and this is 0. And if you won't believe, you may call this one to be M over here, minus 396.8, and then this one is going to be the area over here plus 600. So M is going to be 600. This one negative is positive, but you move it over here, it's going to be T96.2. So you get this one to be the positive moment of 203.2. That is going to be the moment diagram for this column. And then you got to move this one to the beam. Now you can draw this one again. There is no axial force. Okay, just keep it like this for the shear. Okay, now you have this one for 54.6, right? That is 54.6, and this is going to be your shear kilonewton X meter. And then let's put it into about 6 millimeter. This is going to be plus 54.6, and dV by dx is equal to minus 20. And you see, this is 105.4, and this one will move up like this to cross the diagram. So this one minus 105.4. You may check it by doing calculation if you prefer. So you're going to get this one to be 0. And then if you like to check the shear over here, this is point C, and then what we have over here is going to be what we sub C. We sub C minus over here minus 54.6. Okay, and then it's going to be the area over here minus 20 times 8. So V sub C is minus 160 plus 54.6. Okay, and then you can see this one is going to be minus 105.4 kilonewton. You may check like this. Okay, and then over here, you have this one for what? For 54.6 divided by slope. So this one is 54.6 divided by 20. And then you get this one for 2.23 meter. Okay. And then the moment diagram, you get this one X meter. And now you put this one in moment in kilonewton meter. What you have over here is 203.2. Okay, so let's check. This one is about 1 or 10 millimeter. And if you use this size convention, you can see this M equal to 203.2. Or you can see this is clockwise direction. So this one is going to be plus 203.2. And then there is the slope over here. That is going to be dm by dx equal to 54.6. And then this one will up until over here, dm by dx equal to 0. What's going to be the moment over here? The moment over here minus 203.2, and then is equal to 1/2 of 2.23 and times 54.6. Okay, if you do the calculation, you will get m equal to 277.7 kilonewton meter. So you should have this one to 77.7. And then over here is the roller. It is 0. And then for sure, the curve will drop from here to here with curve. And then you have this one, dm by dx equal to minus 105.4. Everything have the reason, okay, how thing like this. So this is positive, okay? The curve will be something like this. This one is negative. The curve will be like this. This is positive. The curve will be like what I draw for you. So let me put this one elastic curve over here. It's going to be clearer. That's going to be about 3 something meter under the application of the force. For sure, this is fixed. This fixed the move. The theta A equal to delta sub AX equal to delta sub AY equal to 0. No movement at all over here. This is 60 kilonewton. And then this is the roller. The roller must move to this point. And if the roller moves to this point, let's say it's moved by 8 millimeter. So over here, you got to put into 8 millimeter your point B, okay, under the application of this loading will again move to this point B palm. And then, as you know, the length that is moved, the displacement delta sub C X and this one delta sub B X, they are equal. Okay, they are equal. Since delta sub B X equal to delta sub C X, since okay, the axial deformation of the beam is, let's say, negligible. Okay, negligible. Okay, and then also the delta sub by is equal to zero, since the axial deformation of the column AB is very small. Okay, you may call it infinitesimal small. And then by doing this, the deflection in this one and deflection in this one in the opposite direction, this must curve. But since it start like this, so this one supposed to curve like this, okay, at this point, and then it will take the curve like this. What we have is the angle over here, still keep it in angle. This is going to be what so called the inflection point. Okay, the point that the curve just change from concave this way to concave this way. And for this one, okay, the deformation just curve as a simple beam. And then what we have is going to be theta sub C. And again, if you compare the slope at this point with respect to the beam in the horizontal direction, the column in the vertical direction, you will get this one to be the theta sub C. Okay, and later next course, you will have a chance to determine the value of the sideway, this one called sideway, or you call the horizontal linear displacement or horizontal deflection whatsoever, and the slope, this one supposed to be theta sub B. Okay, this is the first problem. I spent an hour for this problem to show you guys on the whole picture of this problem, and let me like you guys to compare to what I just show you on this one. Most of the time I will provide you some information that will help you in the calculation of delta sub CY. Okay, and that's going to be a little bit easier. But anyway, I request you guys to go back, recall what you have in the chapter 7, which is the heart of this chapter 8. Okay, let me move to the next example. Next example is last year examination. Again, we're going to work on the problem with the degree of indeterminacy equal to 1. We have fixed and roller. For this one, we have the problem with pin. Okay, and then it's going to be a little bit different because at this point, there is 3 reactions over here and 1 reaction over here. Okay, so we select C sub Y as our redundant. For this one, sometimes to make your guy work in the same direction, I will set the B sub X as your redundant. Okay, this one, you determine the proper redundant force. But this one I given to you because there is 2 at A and also 2 at B. So it's going to be a little bit hard for your guy to select. That's why I do it for you. Okay, by doing this, you may see there is going to be a sub x, a sub y, and b sub x as the redundant, and b sub y will be will determine later. Okay, let me move to this one and again check the degree of determinacy. The OI of this problem again, we have 4 unknown and 4 minus 3 equal to 1, and then B sub X is assigned to be the redundant force. Redundant force by using the principle of superposition, we have principle of superposition. Okay, we have two statically determinate frame. This is 5. This is 4. Okay, let me put this one onto over here. Let's say this is 2.5 meter and this is 2 meter. So your frame can be separate. Okay, by this one, this going to be pinned the same as before. This one only B sub Y. So we put this one into the roller, and then we just apply this loading, and this one will be the primary frame. Okay, that is the frame subjected to the given loading, 16 kilonewton per meter. And then you must combine this one by another frame. This is going to be 2.5. Okay, and then this is about 2, and this is a little bit smaller. Previously I put it 3.5. It's okay, just put it another centimeter to make it a little bit in the proportion. And then again, this is pin. Okay, this is the roller, and then you just put the B sub X over here, and you can see the combination of these two is going to be this one. And then you got to draw the elastic curve under the application of this 16 kilonewton. This one will defect very close to what? Very close to simple beam. And this column will be a straight line because there is no moment, only the axial force occur here. So this one has no curve, okay, different from this one. And then what we said, the movement over here, that's occur at point B. So we call it delta sub B. If you prefer, you may put X, okay, but make it to be simple. That said, it's going to be delta sub B. And for this one, under this roller, for sure, this one will move. Since this one is moved, for sure, this one will have the curve, okay? And then when this one curve is going to keep this one as its right angle, okay? And then this one will have this kind of the formation, and you keep this one at the right angle, the roller still in this way, and then the horizontal displacement over here is going to be delta sub B prime, and then you may put it to be F sub B at point B load apply in this B direction. Okay, the first B at point B. The second B due to the load B sub X. And then time B sub X. And you will get the compatibility condition. Now, based upon this, you may write compatibility at point B. Okay, you may have this one to be 0 equal to, if you put this one positive delta sub B, and then this is going to be negative F sub V B, and then B sub X. Now your B sub X is going to be delta sub B divided by F sub B B, and this one is going to be the main equation used to determine the redundant force. And the problem come to solving for the delta sub B and F sub BB again. I will show you guys about this. Okay, let me move to the third step. We will find what? Find delta B and F sub BB. Let's see by using the method of virtual work. Let's use this method of virtual work. And let me start by determining the delta sub B first. So just put this one 1.0 and then time, let's put it delta sub B, and it's going to be integration dx over EI. And then you determine what? You determine moment due to the loading. So capital M. And you got to put one. The first one, you may put it in this direction or any direction that you like. Okay. And this one, when you put this one, let B sub X equal to 1 is opposite this. You will get delta sub B in the negative direction if you put this one to determine the small m. Okay, don't worry, the elastic curve will help you. Okay, and then based upon this, we come to the point to determine the moment over here. If you prefer, you may use this one, and let me put it in another frame over here to make it a little bit convenient to do the computation. Okay, let me zoom it in, and under the application of 16 kilonewton meter between point A and point B, we can determine the B sub Y over here. And also we can determine A sub Y and this one A sub X. And again, if you do the summation of X sub X equal to 0, A sub X is going to be 0. And you may use this area. This is going to be 5 meters. This is 4 meters. Do the summation of the moment at A equal to 0. B sub Y rotate in counterclockwise direction and going to time 5. So 5 B sub Y. And then again, this one going to rotate in the opposite direction equal to 16 times 5 times 2.5. Okay, and then 5, get rid of them, is going to be 16 times 2.5. So B sub Y is going to be 40 kilonewton. So B sub Y is 40 kilonewton. And then you may put to be summation of F sub y equal to 0 upward is positive, A sub y upward, okay, plus 40, and then it's going to be equal to 16 times 5. So your A sub y is going to be what, 40 kilonewton. Okay, that's due to the symmetry of this 40 kilonewton. Now you need to consider the integration and let the integration from A to this point, let's say C, this one is x1, and let's this one is gonna be x2, and then just cut this portion. We're going to determine the bending moment due to the loading over here. Just cut it over here due to the application of this 16 kilonewton per meter. And again, you have this one for 40 kilonewton. And then this is going to be M1, okay, and basis up on this x1, you do the summation of the moment equal to 0. Just take moment over here. M1 is going to be plus 16 times x1, and times x1 divided by 2, and they rotate in the same direction, and it's equal to 40 x1. So you get M1 to be 40 x1, this one minus 8 x1 square. So this is going to be your first M1 equation. And if you do a good planning, just cut this one, and then you use this one as your B sub y, and based upon this x2, and use this one, you may summation moment equal to 0. So your M2 is 0. That is going to be the moment, capital M. And now if you move a little bit to this point, and you may use this B sub x equal to 1 to do the same computation. Let me put it over here. Okay, let me put this one and this one, and let this one to be 1.0. So we will have the reaction over here, and over here, and over here, the same as this one, just set B sub x equal to 1. And by doing this, if you plug this one, and you see it's going to be in the opposite direction, so don't worry, delta sub B is going to be negative, okay, but it's going to corresponding to elastic curve, which helping us to do the computation. And then basis up on this, if you do the summation moment at A equal to 0, let's put this one B sub y times this one for 5 meter, 5 B sub y in the counterclockwise direction, but 1.0 going to time 4 meter, and it's going to rotate in this direction. So 1 times 4. So B sub y is going to be 4 over 5, 0.8. So this one is going to be 0.8. And if you do the summation of x sub x equal to 0, A sub x will be 1. Okay, if you do the summation of f sub y equal to zero. That one is positive. A sub y will equal to 0.8. So this one is going to be 0.8, and this one is going to be 1. Now do the same thing. Just cut this portion and put it over here. You will get the first portion with reference to the coordinate x1. This is 0.8, and this is going to be 1.0. And the moment over here will be small m1. And based upon this, you may do the summation of the moment equal to 0. You can see 0.8 rotate in the same direction of m1, so it's going to be minus 0.8 x1. okay, this one produce no moment here, and then you may cut on this portion, and this portion corresponding to what we know is going to be x2, and then this has 1.0, and also over here 0.8, use the same direction over here. This is small m2, okay, small m2. Summation of the moment equal to 0. You can see 1 has the opposite direction of this one, so this one will be 1 times x2. And now you are ready. Just plug everything into this equation. What you get, the first integration, you integrate from A to C. That is 5 meters, integrate 0 to 5. And you have this one, 40x1 minus sx1 and square. Okay, and this m1 will time this one, so it's going to time minus 0.8 x1 and dx1 over this one. There is only ei, okay, just divided by ei. And the also one m2 time this one is 0, so plus 0. Doing this, you will get this one to be equal to, okay, 333. Let me take a look at it. 0.433 divided by EI, and you see this is going to be in this direction, okay, for sure it's going to be negative. And then what you have, the second one is going to be 1.0 times what we have is f sub this one bd equal to the integration. Now you can see this one produces the capital M if it is b sub x. We didn't use b sub x, we use b sub x equal to 1, so it's reduced into small m, capital M, change to small m, and m still the same. We like to determine the deflection in the horizontal direction, so it's going to do to the load of 1.0 unit load, and then divided by integrated, divided by EI. Now what we have is we have this one integrate again from this one to this one 0.5, and basis up on this is going to be, even though it's negative, okay, and it's going to be square, and dx1 divided by ei, and then the second portion plus this one, okay, is going to be positive, but this one integration from point B to Hoisi is 4 meters, integrates from 0 to 4, and then x2 squared dx2 over EI. Now, you do the computation, you will get this one, 48 divided by EI, okay? And then this one will follow this direction. Okay, just take a note, copy it. Step four, this is going to be step four. We will find B sub X from this one. We have B sub X equal to 3.433, if I correct, supposed to be how I write thing like this. It's not very clear, but it's okay. It should be, if it's not 333, it's supposed to be 43, right? Let me take a look at it. 4423. No, it's gonna be 333, not 43. It's supposed to be like this. And then divided by EI. And again, for this F sub BB, it's gonna be 48 divided by EI. So your B sub X is gonna be 6.94 kilonewton. And then this is gonna be 6.94 kilonewton. So you may determine the next step. Just step five, find reactions. Okay, and again, the shear diagram, M diagram, and elastic curve. Okay, by doing this, I just use the area that we just determine this. So we got to work in the area on the bottom of it. Okay. At this point, what do we get? The deflection of the primary frame. This is going to be 333.333 divided EI. And this one is correct. Okay. Sometimes I also provide you guys one of it. But on this problem, I just show you every way to solve, not every way, to solve for both deflection basis on the method of virtual work. Okay. And then next, we may do the calculation of this. If you prefer, you may use this area. You may do the summation, take it over here, and zoom it in, moment over A equal to zero. So by doing this, your B sub Y going to rotate in counterclockwise direction. B sub Y has this line of action, is going to time 5. And then this one, okay, will rotate in the opposite direction. So it's going to be minus 6.94. This one has the line of action over here and time 4. And then we have this one, 16.5, and it's going to rotate, okay, in this way. So minus, right, minus 16 times 5 times 2.5, and then you will get B sub Y to be 45.6 kilonewton, okay? And then B sub Y equal to 45.6 kilonewton. And then if you do the summation of X sub X equal to 0, you will get A sub X to be 6.94 kilonewton. And the last one, if you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0, your A sub Y upward. Okay, and then A sub Y plus 45.6, and then it's going to be equal to 16 times 5. You will get your A sub Y to be 34.4 kilonewton. And then coming to drawing the shear diagram, moment diagram, you got to separate this frame. Let's put this one, okay, about as you prefer, you may put it into 5 centimeter, okay. Okay, and then this is going to be the area to draw the shear and moment diagram. And let me put on this side to be the column. Let's see, this is V, this is the C, C and A, and this is 16 kilonewton per meter. Let me answer A sub X. A sub X is 6.94, okay, in this direction. A sub Y 34.4 in the upward direction. B sub X 6.94 in this direction. You see, the direction of them, they are different. V sub Y is 45.6 and upward. Please indicate the direction of the reaction also. And then you just put the reaction to be here. That is going to be 6.94 kilonewton. And this one, A sub Y, 34.4 kilonewton. And again, this one is going to be B sub Y, 45.6 kilonewton. And the last one over here, that is going to be the B sub X. Okay, that is going to be 6.94 kilonewton over here. Then you need to determine the reaction over here. Then this is going to be 45.6 kilonewton for sure. Summation of F sub Y equal to 0. And this one supposed to be 6.94 kilonewton. And see, if you take the moment over here, 6.94 will times 4 meter have this moment. So in this way, we got to have the moment act here. That moment is going to be 6.94 times 4. That is going to be 27.46 kilonewton. And then this one actually is will act passing to point C. This moment will apply to here and apply to here. Okay, and then this one is going to be 27.76 kilonewton. And you can check, okay, with this one, this is going to be 5 meter. Again, 5.6 going to be upward here and downward here. And it's supposed to be this one, okay, 45.6 kilonewton. And then 6.94 is will act and will act in this direction and in this direction and in this direction, and 6.94 will balance with this one, 6.94 kilonewton. Okay, and then later we may draw the normal force diagram later. Okay, for this one, let me start by drawing the shear diagram. And this is X meter, this from 0 to 5 meter. And this one is going to be V in kilonewton. And what we have is 34.4 is upward. So you may put this one to be two times of it, about 7 millimeter if you prefer. That's it's going to be 34.4. And then dV by dx equal to minus 16. And believe me, over here is 45.6 for sure. That is going to be about 9 millimeter. You got to close this one upward. So this one is minus 45.6. And then you get this one as your shear diagram. And the shear over here is zero. The distance over here will be 34.4 times the slope, 34.4 divided, not time, divided by the slope. And then it's going to be 2.15 meter. Now we made the moment diagram, and let me put this one to be the M in kilonewton meter. This is X meter. We have this one zero, this one 5, and this point has zero slope. And starting here, there is no external moment. So this is zero. And then what we have is the slope over here, the dm by dx equal to this one, 34.4. And then up until here, the slope is zero, but we don't know the value of the moment over here yet. The moment over here, minus zero, equal to the area over here, 1/2 of 2.15, and times 34.44. So you get the moment over here to be 36.98 kilonewton meter. This one is going to be 36.98. And you know this one, dm by dx equal to zero. So the curve is something like this. And then what is going to be 27.46? You made the conventional sign, and you see m plus 27.76 is zero. So this one is going to be negative. So just put this one over here, and then minus 27.76. And the slope over here is going to be dm by dx equal to minus 45.6. Then the curve is going to be something like this. And this one just goes up because clockwise moment going to positive. Okay, to cross this one, and this one is zero. It's going to be the inflection point. And if you prefer, and if you prefer and you like to, you may draw the normal force diagram, and you can see this is may put to be N kilonewton, and it is in comprehension of 9.6.94. which is about 10 times less than this. So the value of here is small, and it's going to be minus 6.94 kilonewton is here. And this is going to be the normal or axial force diagram. This is moment diagram, and this is going to be shear diagram. Okay, and then for the column, it's better for us to rotate it in this direction and just put it over here. And what we're going to do, this one is 4, this one is 0, X meter. And over here we have V kilonewton. What we have is here 6.94. Okay, that is change similar to the normal force diagram, but this one change to the shear and it's going to be very small, plus 6.94 dv by dx equal to 0. So just close this one and close this one, plus 6.94. And then we draw next the moment diagram of this one and x and then meter. And for this one, it's going to be m kilonewton meter. This point is pin, okay? The moment is 0 from 0 to 4. And then the value of this dm by dx is plus 6.94. So this one will be up like this. And for sure, if you put the sign convention, this one and this one going to be in the opposite direction, okay? And this one will be the moment of 24.46. And then what we have, this is counterclockwise. So this is just cross our moment diagram. And based upon this, this is positive. This is going to be the deflection of the column. And then this is going to be the deflection of the column. And this is going to be the negative. So based upon this, under this force, the beam will have concave upward and then concave downward. So if you come over here, the beam is supposed to deflect like this, concave upward, and then it's going to concave downward like this. And then the column over here will have the curve, okay, have the curve like this. And then it's supposed to have this kind of deformation. And I should say this one is going to be the inflection point, okay? And what else do we have? Based upon this, you may have the slope over here. Later, next course, we can determine it theta sub b. Actually, we can determine it here, but it's going to be really hard to do so. And because we got to use the unit load method, but next course, we will use the displacement method to solve it. It's going to be very easy. And then again, based upon this, you have the tangential line, okay, that's going to noise like this. It's going to be theta sub c, okay? And do it have the shortening of the column or the axial deformation of the column and of the beam? No, the delta sub cx equal to delta sub cy equal to 0, since there is no, we consider no axial deformation of the beam and column, okay? That's going to explain to us for classical analysis. We don't consider the axial deformation, but later in the structural analysis, we may do the computation and we will see the deformation is going to be very small. Okay, very small. This is another kind of example that I like to show you guys. The first one is fixed and roller. Okay, and this one is going to be pinpin, okay, for our scope of the study. And then let me introduce you guys to another one to finish the last type of problem that we should have again. We have what? The pinpin. However, this one we have two columns and one beam. And then could it be something like this? This is fixed and this is roller. Yes, it is. It can be, and it's maybe this is fixed and this is roller. The combination of the support can be anything, but I scope our study to be the frame with the degree of indeterminacy of only one, since we have very limited time to solve the problem. And the other thing I should mention, the beam may be different from the moment of inertia of the beam may be different from the moment of inertia of the column. This one has two EI and this one actually has only constant EI, has a constant stiffness EI. This has EI, EI, but this one has two EI. So beware about it because the integration will involve with it, okay? And then based up on this, okay, I usually may help you guys to provide the deformation of the structure. I may provide you the deflection due to the applied loading, or I also may provide you only the deflection due to the redundant force of 1.0 unit. But anyway, after we check the degree of indeterminacy, we have this is 4 - 3 = 1. And then this one will guide you to use the redundant at point D to be your redundant. And then may I use A sub Y, A sub X? Okay, you may use A sub X, or you may use A sub Y, even though you may use D sub X and D sub Y. And if I specify like this, please follow what I said, okay? And I ask you guys to go back to solve. For example, this one, if I use A sub X as the redundant, what the analysis of the structure should be? Or not typically asking you to use the B sub Y as the redundant or A sub Y as redundant. Okay, that is going to be a little bit tougher, but just use, for example, horizontal force. That's going to be a little bit easier. Okay, they use this one. So again, you may say that is going to be step one. And by using the principle of superposition, again, always refer to this one because we can separate the frame into actually statically into two statically determinate frame. Okay, so we can solve for the deflection of that statically determinate. We separate because we looking for the structure that we can use our previous knowledge to solve it. That's the way they think. And then again, based upon this, I may put this one to be D sub Y, this one to be A sub Y, this one to be A sub X. And to be clear, this is going to be the redundant force. And by doing this, you got to change the pin over here to be the roller. And by doing that, let me put it like this. This is 4 meter and say this is maybe small, take it a small one, and this is going to be 1.5, and this is only 1 centimeter. What we have is this one going to be pin, this one going to be the roller, and then you may put this one as the D sub X as your redundant under the application of this 2 kilonewton, 2 kilonewton per meter. Again, these two frames, they are equivalent, and then we separate, okay, this one into two frames. Let me put it like this. This is 2, 4 meter, 4 meter into centimeter, and then this one 3 meter, this one 2 meter, this one 3 meter, and this one 2 meter under the force 2 kilonewton per meter. We can analyze this frame, okay, according to what we discussed in chapter 7, and we call this is as the primary frame, okay, primary frame. And then this second frame is only subjected to D sub X, and again you can see combination of them provide that with this frame, which is equivalent to this one. And then what we have is second step, okay, the compatibility condition at what? At point D, Richard, at D, what we have is 0 equal to under this one. This one cannot move, okay, you got to see, since this one cannot move under the application of this force, this one supposed to bend like this, because over here you have both A sub X and A sub Y, but this one you have only D sub Y. This one may have this kind of deformation with some size way, and then the column here should be straight line, because there is only axial loading on this column. And then what we have is the deformation over here is going to be delta sub D, you may put X, okay, or you may not, depend on what you like. And again, for the second picture, the D will move. This one will a little bit more complicated, is when it's moved like this, and there is no movement over here, because the beam and the column can move, right? A little bit move, because it's just move in this direction, because this one may be curved, okay, and then by doing this, the deformation over here will be a little bit complicated. It's supposed to keep this one, and this one is going to keep its right angle. And then again, what we have is the horizontal displacement is going to be F sub D D and time D X, okay, and then by doing this, you got to have this one delta sub D if this one is positive, and this one is going to be minus F sub D D, and then it's going to be D sub X, and by this one, you will get D sub X equal to delta sub D divided by F sub D D. Again, it's come to chapter 7, okay, to solve for the deflection, both delta sub D and F sub DD. And then that is going to be a very big problem if we got to solve for it. Okay, let us start step number three. We will find delta sub D and F sub DD. Again, by using the method of virtual work, you do the same thing. 1.0 apply in this direction, but in opposite this one. And we going to determine delta sub D. Again, it's going to be integrate of this one for the capital M, and maybe this one for the small m, and dx over EI. Now, let us consider this frame first, okay? And then we will determine the small m later. Based us upon this, let us have this one, two centimeter for 4 meter, and this one, let us determine the reaction under the application of 2 kilonewton per like this. You may has this one to be D sub Y, and this one to be A sub Y, and this one to be A sub X, summation of X sub X equal to C sub, so it's 0. A sub X is 0. If you take the moment over here, summation of the moment at A equal to 0. This is going to be 4 meter D sub Y. 4 D sub Y rotate in this direction. This one is 2 equal to 2 times 4. It's going to be 8. And then times 2. You just cut. Okay, D sub Y is going to be 4 kilonewton. D sub Y equal to 4 kilonewton. So A sub X is equal to 4 kilonewton by doing the summation of F sub Y equal to 0. A sub Y equal to what? This is 8 kilonewton. 8 minus 4 is equal to 4 kilonewton. Okay. That is going to be in very close area. Okay, but you got to work on very, very appropriate way to make everything together. Okay, and please consider the size of the drawing for appropriate calculation. Then you got to select. Let's put this one to be X1, and let me again put this one to be X2, and this one to be X3. And if you do that, this one will be the first size. And for this one, you may move this X1 a little bit to this area. Let me put this one to be X1, and then we cut this one over here, and we have this one for 4 kilonewton, and we may put this one to be M1, and M1 is going to be 0. Because there is A sub X equal to 0 and only the axial force. And for this portion, again, it's going to be the same. Okay, this is going to be 4 kilonewton. And then you may see this one. Let's take the moment over here. M3 is 0. Summation is moment equal to 0, and if you prefer, summation of moment equal to 0 here. And then for this portion, you may cut it and draw it over here. And then what you get again is going to be the force of 4 kilonewton. and this one is going to be 2 kilonewton per meter, and that area is very close. Why don't I zoom it? And then if you take this one is going to be x2. This is going to be capital M2, summation of the moment equal to zero. What you have is M2 rotate in this direction. And then you have this one plus 2 times x2, and then x2 over here divided by 2, and then it's equal to 4 times x2. So um, m2 is going to be 4x2 minus this one, and move it in this way, x2 square. So only this one have the moment over here. Okay, and then not finished yet. You got to determine another frame having this kind of 1.0 unit load. Let me put this way, the same way we did on this area. We will compute the deflection of the frame later. Okay, let me put this one. This is 4 meter, and this is 3 meter. This is 2 meter. We have this one for 1.0, and then what we has is the this one for a sub x. And if we take the moment over here, this one will rotate in this direction, and I believe this one supposed to rotate in the other direction. Let's say this one is in this way. This one supposed to be in this way. This is going to be d sub y, and this is going to be a sub y again. This is 4 meter, 3 meter, 2 meter. If you do the summation of the moment at a equal to zero, your d sub y 4 times d sub y, that is going to be in the clockwise direction. Okay, and this one equal to 1 times this one is going to be 1, so d sub y is going to be 1/4. So versus up on this one, d sub y is 0.25. you do the summation of f sub y equal to 0, so this a sub y also 0.25. if you do the summation of x sub x equal to 0, this is going to be 1.0. okay, and then you do the same calculation. You may cut okay over here, and then this is going to be upward 0.25, and what we have is going to be x1, and you have this one for a sub x to be 1.0. follow the direction of capital M over here. This one M1 summation of the moment equal to 0 is going to be negative x1 because it's in the same direction. Okay, and then if you cut over here again, you will have this one and this one to be 1.0, and do the summation of the moment equal to 0 here. You got this one for M3, and they are in the opposite direction of x3. So this one gonna be M3 equal to x3. And then if you again cut in this portion and draw the free body diagram of your frame, this one is going to be 0.25, and this one is 1.0. you may determine this one to be M1, sorry, M2, you take moment over here. This is going to be 3 meters. And this is going to be X2. And then summation of the moment equal to 0. And rotate, this one is positive. So this one plus 3 times 1. It's going to be in the same direction. This one will be in the opposite direction, 0.25 times X2. So M2 is going to be 0.25 X2 minus 3. Okay, and now you may do the computation of this. So the first integration, let's see, for this one, produce 0. And then plus the second one, you integrate this one by this one, integrate from this point B to C for 4 meters, 0 to 4. You integrate 4x2 minus x2 square. And then this one, you may put into 0.25 x2 and minus 3. And the x2 divided by this one, 2ei. Okay. And then on the third one, you have this to be 0. So the third one provide plus 0. Okay. And then after you do the integration, you will get to be equal to, okay, compared to what you draw the elastic curve, and this one, you should get the negative, okay, and then it's conclude that you get it to be 13.33 EI, and has this direction. And then the other one, you may have, again, the F sub, dd 1.0 times f sub dd equal to, now integration will be small m square. So the first one, you integrate from here to here for 3 meters, 0 to 3, and this one minus x1 square, dx1 divided by ei, and then plus the second one, integrate from this one, 0 to 4, and you use this one, 0.25 x2 minus 3 square, dx2 divided by this one, 2ei. And the last one over here, you integrate from this point to this point, is 2 meters, integrate from 0 to 2. And this one minus x3 square, dx3, this one, ei. And then you supposed to get the integration of this to be 24.33 divided by ei. Okay, and then what you may go next, okay, let's we put it over here. We go to the step number 4. We find d sub x. Okay. And based upon what we find over here, the first one is going to be 13.33 divided by ei. Follow its direction. And this one is going to be in this direction. And then that is going to be 24.33 divided by EI. And you supposed to get this one to be what the number over here? The force to be 0.547547 kilonewton. This one will be 0.547 kilonewton. Okay, and then that's all the time we have. And I actually have the lecture note, I think, on this problem in my video clip. But anyway, if you prefer, I will take the picture of this problem and we'll post it in the Facebook group, okay, in order you guys can work on this problem until you can draw the shear diagram moment diagram for the beam and shear moment diagram for the column, draw the elastic curve, and also draw the reinforcement. And for the time being, I should thank you, all of you, to attend my class. And we will have the last lecture on Thursday. Okay, enjoy your night. Goodbye.